favor, we shall win.
Whether we rise
or whether we fall, we'll do our best to please you all.
Hard times with good company, I love and shall until I die. God, true love, what lovely time. So God, be pleased, thus it will lie. For my heart's hunt, hunting and dance, my heart is set. Oh, goodly sport, for my comfort, who shall me let? Youth must have some dalliance, of good or ill, some past
chance.
Company, methinks them best, all thoughts and fancies to digest. For idleness is chief mistress of vices all. Then who can say but mirth and play is best of all?
Room for me, my broom. Ready, gallants, give us room to rhyme. We've sport to share this Christmas time.
We scream the fiddle, bang the drum, and all shall know the mum is come.
So give us entry, clear the way, allow us perform our play.
There's mirth and merriment in store, the like was never seen before.
And there you have it, that's the reason our play begins the festive season.
And should you grant us your permission, we'll carry on our fine tradition. For we know there are plenty here who'll show us welcome, give us cheer.
And what is more, once we begin, your like has not be joining in.
So raise your voices, gentles all,
and welcome us to Anson Hall.
I hope old Father Christmas will never be forgot. A plump of pudding and a hopkins pie, just the stuff for you and I.
Now, Anson counts itself among the healthy schools, but in the Christmas spirit, we've relaxed those irksome rules. We're pleased to say Miss Lexico seemed fit to authorise the annual distribution of traditional pies.
With this in mind, we ask you all to join us, if you please, in welcoming the season with a riotous reprise.
Mince pies cold, mince pies cold, mince pies in a pot 9 days old.
The winter blues will soon assuage, but who is next to take the stage?
It's I, the Queen of Egypt, as you all can plainly see. Come forward, knight, and show yourself before this company.
My name is Alexander. And from Macedon I came to fight in bloody battle and to triumph in the same. From Thrace through Babylonia to the far Arabian Sea, the world is mine. And yet, I'm but approaching 33.
Knight, I'm compelled to make an interjection. Approaching 33, you say, but pray from what direction?
I am a valiant soldier, and Bolt Slasher is my name. With sword and buckler by my side, I'm sure to win the game. I'm rough and tough and muscular, I'm full of vim and vigour. I'm masculine and macho, and I cause a man
figure. Again, I have to intervene. You're starting to annoy. Although you claim to be a man, you're clearly just a boy.
Topsy-turvy.
if I may speak with candor, the old man should play Slasher and the boy play Alexander.
What you suggest, Your Majesty, is obvious and crude, and frankly, most offensive.
Yes, indeed.
How very rude.
But that aside, your glib solution doesn't help one bit. We can't swap parts at this stage. Does it cost you?
I am the maid of Orion, descended Joan of Arc. Believe me, I may be queen. My bite is worse than my bark. My armor may be borrowed, suit to I my sword and lance. But I'm clothed in glory, and my cry is Vive la France!
Make way for Boadicea! Warrior queen and British hero, the scourge of Roman soldiers and the nemesis of Nero! I see these mine by rights, but when denied my due dominion, I put the torch to Colchester, St. Albans and Londinium!
I am Isabella of Castile, so cringe, Catal and Cower. With me as queen, Spain will become a global power. Take care, you English curse, for my result will never falter. I'll take on any adversary, and then I'll take Gibraltar!
Surely burst!
He's such a gorgeous ham
and dish.
The only one for we? Me.
You wish.
I am Sir George, from England sprung, a champion, brave and bold. Oh, thank you very much. The glorious deeds of my stories throughout the world are told.
And I'm Sir George's maid of all work, humble yonder e. Although my name is Gertrude, everybody calls me Gertie.
Though frightening be the fighting, and formidable the fray, I'll face the foe with fearlessness and fortitude.
Hooray! Right now, girls, it's quite enough. Leave poor Sir George alone.
And who are you?
Skibby.
I don't think I like your tone.
I know my place. I'm just a drudge. I'm filthy and I smell. And once a year, I have a bath. And I scrub up pretty well. I'm always at Sir George's side. I'm loyal, brave, and true. And if you wanted romance, you look at me, not you.
Braver still and even keener.
Our parents lacked creative thought, so I am called Georgina.
I thrust a man in any duel, I trumped him in a scrap. Each victory of mine will have to close the gender gap.
Enough, you English dogs, enough. You wouldn't be so hot if you knew who it is who stands before you on this spot. I've travelled here from Macedon, Sir George's tongue to stay, and surely either he or I must die this very day.
My brother has no fight with you? Be gone, you loathsome churl!
Nobody talks to me like that, especially a girl! You'll rue those disrespectful words. Your family is cursed. I'll kill your brother in a while, but I'll dispatch you first.
Since you desire to fight, I'll chop you up as small as flies and send you to Beelzebub to make mince pie!
Mince pie! Mince pie! Mince pie! Mince pie!
Ah!
Oh, woe is me! What do I see? A hero's blood is spilt!
I cannot tell a lie! 'Twas I brave Alexander killed! He gave me challenge to this bloody fight!
There's no denying it!
Truly said, he made it then, and ergo he must lie in it. He lies as still as stone. A mighty thrust has pierced his torso. This man is dead, it's true to say. A journey can't be more so.
But medical attention, my jet, bring this fellow around.
He needs a doctor now!
Is there a doctor? Is there a doctor to be found?
Yes, of course, it's me. There is a doctor to be found, and I will tell you.
To one the cure for Alexander, what will be your fee?
£10, I suppose. But seeing as it's him, I'll make it three.
A deal.
If your majesty so pleases, I can tackle most diseases. Laryngitis, tonsillitis, other respiratory wheezes. I can cure your sinusitis. I can stop your sniffs and sneezes. I can change her problematic wind to gentle, fragrant breezes. But hold, this man is not as dead as he appears. He merely has a rotten tooth, so dry your misspent tears. This body still and stiff. Nurse, pass me the smelling salt. Here,
Where am I? What has come to pass? My brain is in a whirl. Sir George has surely bested me. It can't have been that girl.
A miracle!
This deed has proved you merciful and brave. You spared my life. And henceforth, I must be your humble slave.
Oh, don't grovel at my feet, Sir Knight. Stand up and off you go. Remember how I bested you. Tell everybody so. Hey!
Such arrogance! He believes it too, I suppose. Ah well, boys will be boys. And hey, it's no skin off my nose.
So saintly, so magnanimous, so virtuous and brave.
My knight in shining armour.
Oh, for goodness sake, behave.
Oh, doctor, won't you help us?
We've been under so much strain.
We're feeble, flushed, and feverish.
Allow us to explain.
Alas, whatever loves. For every time I felt this man is standing next to us, a death comes to my feet, and our pulses start to race. Say, boom, goody, boom, goody, boom, goody, boom, goody, boom, goody, boom, goody, boom, 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 goody, boom, goody, boom, goody, boom, goody, boom, 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 boom,
boom. Come here, my groom. I am Sir George, from England sprung, a champion brave and bold. The stories of my glorious deeds throughout the world are told. I've travelled every country, and I've charted every sea. And honestly, I'd have to say, no man compares to me. Hey!
is also true. Old Slasher is my name, and I'm the physical ideal. My head is made of iron. Ow. And my body's made of steel. Sir George, your whole demeanor is offensive in my sight. Ow!
Well said.
Take up your sword. I challenge you.
Enough! No more! I order your pugnacious prattle cease. You, sirrah, put down your sword and leave us all in peace.
Do you know who you're talking to?
Old Slasher, is it not? It should be to whom you're talking, by the way.
Who gives a jot? Old Slasher, as my name implies.
Sir!
Either you apologise, or I'll be forced to chop you up to make mince pies!
Mince pies home! Mince pies home! Mince pies in the pot, man, there's all the pot!
Man will soon be full of beans. I'll contrive the night's revival in an instant. Nurse, the screams.
Thank you. A sock.
His eyes are closed, his body's cold, and his countenance is pale. But soon the owner of this sock, old Slasher, will inherit.
Who's them? It can only be some chicken or another. Can't have been that girl. It must have been her brother. Pray not your mercy cause my wounds to heal. So as your humble servant, I subserve you.
No, oh, I can't abide a crawler. Please get up, you know the score. Wherever you go, be sure to tell my tale forevermore. Hey!
Again, the knight appears to have the wrong end of the stick. But no one contradicts him, it's enough to make you sick.
So pure of heart, so chivalrous.
So dashing and audacious.
Are these dainty damsel in distress?
Oh, goodness gracious.
Oh, don't worry.
I must intervene. An interlude is due. Two knights defeated, and our play is nearly halfway through. Oh, then let us pause for thought, for Christmas is a time for giving. We therefore bring you gifts, despite the rising cost of living. So, to present what is in truth a blatant panto gag, five players take to the stage. Each carrying a goodie bag!
Now, I've got cheesy Watsons that I'd like to show to you.
And
if you like my Watsons, I'll tell you what I'll do.
What are you going to do?
I'll take my cheesy Watsons and I'll throw them out to you. Who wants my cheesy Watsons?
Now, I have got...
Don't say it. No, please don't.
A curly whirly. A curly whirly. Oh, it's a whirly that's curly. I have a curly whirly that I'd like to show to you. Even though it's a primary school. If you like my curly whirly,
oh my God.
Yeah.
what I'll do. I'll take my curly whirly.
This way.
And I'll throw it out to you.
You four.
Now, I have got two Snickers. I have got two Snickers that I'd like to show to. And if you like my Snickers, I'll tell you what I'll do. Take my pair of Snickers and I'll throw them out to you.
Tom Jones is over here. Now, I have got ginger nuts. I've got ginger nuts.
Who would have thought?
Oh, Mr. Waters, grow up. That I'd like to show to you. And if you like, excuse me. You like my ginger nuts?
No one likes.
I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll take my lovely ginger nuts. And have you guessed it?
For us.
You.
Four.
Yeah,
four.
Give
me your nuts, bro.
Yeah, four.
Yeah, four, man. Come on.
Yeah, four. Oh, come on. Please.
You
guys
are asleep. That's it.
You guys
can. Chocolate eggs! Oh no!
Oh dear!
And gifts with which to win you! However, as enough of that, our play must now continue. Two knights already festive, three more waiting to engage. Oh, such thrills await as once again our hero takes the stage!
I am Sir George from England sprung, a champion brave and bold. halls, the stories of my glorious deeds throughout the world are told! Hooray!
Just a man! So wait the fuss!
You're right, there's only one of him.
And there are three of us.
So George, prepare to die.
We'll pierce your body like a blister.
Your what?
Darling, forgot the sister.
All mad and nerd trousers. They're outnumbered 3-2. Literally, this little upstairs thing is which is what and who is who. Yes, who is who? What is your problem?
It's
all like Mid-Wall's. Stop, Joel! Your hand is nah!
Your skull will crack!
Your blow will flow!
We're throwing down our gauntlets!
So, two down, and three to go. But only when all my foes are vanquished, only then can I relax!
Come on, you. Is that the time?
Can't stick around! I've got to nail appointment, got to hurry, girls! I'm sorry!
I'm missing God. I'm up front. Bye!
Hey! I've proved myself in combat. There is no one who can best me. I've wasted fighting puny knights. Where's the quest to test me?
The quest you crave is near at hand. A mighty dragon stalks this land. If you kill this monstrous beast, you'll win my lovely.
If I should face this monster and the fearsome dragon fell, I won't just want her hand, I want the rest of her as well.
In this case, I can safely say, come hell or hiding water, there's not one part or portion I'd lay claim to of her daughter. Dear brother, you may think the dragon should be overthrown, but I've no quarrel with the beast. The fight is yours alone.
I order you to cease your roar, you egocentric lizard, or else I'll slice you ear to ear and open up your gizzard.
I'm not afraid of you. I'll dash your body on the stones, then I'll gnaw on your arms and legs and suck the marrow from your bones. Within my belly and ice within my heart. I'll bash, slash, gnash you. I'll tear your limbs apart.
You think you're really something, but I'll cut you down to size and send you to Beelzebub to make mince pies.
Mince pies, ho! Mince pies, ho! Mince pies in the pot, and here's your
Come on, guys! Everybody supports me. over here.
And painful kidney stones.
What will you charge?
£50.
No! Although it's very kind of you, alas, it cannot be.
Why not? You've shown compassion having knights resuscitated, but when it comes to animal or mercy has abated, you're machismo, mouth and muscle count for nothing if you dare to best the beast and then leave the creature's carcass lying there.
Enough! It cannot be revived, for so the story goes. Sir George did slay the dragon.
Every Anybody knows!
And so it is that history's twisted time and time again. And we can only raise our eyes to heaven and say, men.
Yeah!
Oh, Doctor, we're beside ourselves.
We've suffered such a blow.
Our hopeless hearts are broken.
Won't you help before you go?
Broken-hearted, the man that we adored is promised to another, and it's death that's been ignored. Our hearts no longer rage as we gaze upon his face. Day when moody, 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 moody,
in search of souls to burn. When bidden by Beelzebub, to hell must I return. Eternity upon a spit above a dripping pan will purge all evil from your soul. Aren't I a jolly old man?
Oh, no, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am. Oh, yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Oh, suit yourselves. Forevermore, this dragon's breath will feed the fires of hell.
No,
I hereby claim this creature's soul! Five, four, three, two, now, mortals, fare
ye well.
Christmas comes, but once a year, but when it comes, it brings good cheer.
So George has killed the dragon, and that's just as it should be. We hope that we've made good sport and pleased the company. Please, judge us not too harshly on the show you've seen before. We've done our best, and truth to say, the best can do no more.
And now a heartfelt wish for everybody gathered here for a peaceful festive season and a prosperous new year.
Christmas and a happy new year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a